Okay, Michael, so I have brought back yet another slide, slightly modified, from the discussion on options and constraints. Do you recognize it? You remember this?
Well, it's got the Pacman thing on it, and it has the four options or whatever that we just talked about, and it has the beginnings of a stoplight.
Right, that's exactly right. Well, so in fact, I told you a little bit about this experiment that we did where we asked people to come up with these options, but there was a second part to the experiment. There are two buttons. This is me attempting to draw what a button looks like. There's a green button and there's a red button. And what you're being asked to do is to watch Pac-Man over here run around, executing actions, including these options you came up with. And then occasionally you're supposed to hit a green or a red button. And what do you think that the green and the red stand for?
Probably green is the Pac-Man did something good, and the red is the Pac-Man did something not so good.
Right, that's exactly right. So this is supposed to mean good, and this is supposed to mean bad, just like you would expect. We have people do this, and they did it. They would say, that's good, that's bad, that's bad, that's bad, that's good, 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 that's bad, and so on and so forth. Now, here's my question to you. Given that people have done all of this, and they've given us lots of data on whether Pac-Man did well or did poorly, what would be kind of the obvious thing to do with that information?
The obvious thing would be, it seems like the right thing, which is to, if you treat the good as a like a plus one and the bad as a minus one, and have the agent just maximize reward, that should basically be reinforcement learning.
Right, and that makes a lot of sense, right? So since we do reinforcement learning, we'd want to turn this into a reinforcement learning problem, and we would say, well, every time you said something was good, I'm going to treat that as a reward of, say, one. It doesn't really matter. And bad, say, is something like that, and you get a reward for, say, being in a state and taking a particular action. And that's a perfectly reasonable thing to do. And in fact, this ends up being a way to get human beings to help us to sort of automatically do reward shaping. And in fact, you can show this works pretty well. And there's been a lot of work on this. We provided some papers on this for the students to read about. And you do better, as you might imagine, by treating these things as reward shaping than if you didn't. Because really, they're hints as you sort of move along about where you ought to be and the kinds of things you ought to do. But remember what I said before, that human beings actually are trying to tell you something, and they might be trying to tell you something different from what you want them to be. So if I think back to what you just said, what you kind of said is, well, look, it's a reinforcement learning problem. Reinforcement learning problems need rewards, and so we should convert these things into rewards. Well, it turns out that in practice, when you actually talk to humans and kind of work out what they do, they're not actually doing this. When they say good and they say bad, they're not thinking in terms of actual rewards, plus one, minus one, or plus 10 and minus nine and these kinds of things, because of course they're not reinforcement learning experts. They're not thinking about rewards. They're actually giving you a different kind of information. So here, let me just ask you, if I told you in English that you should hit the green button whenever the agent does something right and the red button when the agent does something wrong, then what kind of information am I conveying other than a reward value?
Well, one way to put it is you're giving commentary on the behavior or the policy.
That's exactly right. That really, in fact, it turns out, you could convert these things into rewards, but you could also convert them into something that's a bit more direct. You can just say, well, you're actually telling me that in this particular state, I should, in fact, take this action, or that in this particular state, I should not take this action. And this is direct policy advice as opposed to reward advice. And so maybe what we're really doing is not reward shaping, or what humans are doing is not reward shaping, it's actually policy shaping.